Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing chapter 14, that is practical geometry. And in this chapter, in our last class, we have finished with exercise 14.3, which is related to constructing a copy of a given line segment. Today we will be starting with perpendiculars. What do we mean by perpendicular? Two lines which are intersecting at one point, and if they are intersecting, the angle which is formed in between, that is right angle. And then we will say that one line is perpendicular to another line. For example, we have taken these two lines. One is L, another one is L. And when these two lines were intersecting with each other, the angle which is forming here, that is of 90 degree. So we will say that line L is perpendicular to line M. Or L is perpendicular to M, simply. So line L is perpendicular to M, or line L is perpendicular to line M. Perpendicular, this symbol also you can use it, and you can write it in the words also. So perpendicular means when two lines intersect with each other and they are forming 90 degree angle with each other. That is your perpendicular. Now perpendicular only we are going to do it. Today we will learn how to construct a perpendicular. Fine, if you have been given with a line, and you need to draw a perpendicular. Now, parallel and perpendicular lines are not a new concept for you all. In your previous class, class 5, you have learned how to draw parallel and perpendicular lines with set square. Now here what we are going to learn, here we will be learning that how to make perpendicular of a given line. So let's start with one of that question. If you were given a line and using ruler and compass we will be doing it, how you are going to draw a perpendicular line using ruler and compasses. So there are certain ways to draw this. Now how you can draw it? For example, you have been given with a line, fine, given with a line. Somewhere we are going to mark a point P. Line L. Somewhere here we are going to draw a point P. We'll put a compass here and mark any arc. Here we are going to put the compass and make an arc. Now this name it A and B. Now you need to draw a perpendicular bisector. So directly we are not going to write it. What we are going to do it? Here we are going to make an arc with this and with this. And then we are going to join this point with this point. Now this is your perpendicular which is forming 90 degree. Okay. Now let's see. This is one of the methods. What will be steps? Step, for example, let's see the steps. How you are going to draw a perpendicular of a given line. Let's see. Draw a line L. On this line L, somewhere we'll take one point, put pointer of the compass and make an arc. Now open the compass more than half, keep it here, make an arc here and other one also here. And then join this arc. Make an arc here and then this arc. Then join this arc with this point. With this point and it is forming 90 degree angle. Now P, name it Q. Fine. So PQ is perpendicular to line A. PQ is perpendicular to line A. So PQ is perpendicular. So that is one of the method to draw a perpendicular. Draw a line, make an arc, open the arc more than half, put a cross here, and then here, and cut it, and point join the points. And then you can find it out. It's perpendicular. Now here, PQ is perpendicular on line A. Now let's see questions from exercise 14.3 up to 14.3. We have finished in our last class. So we'll be starting with exercise 14.4. Question 1. Draw any line segment AP. Mark any point M on it. Through M, draw a perpendicular to AP. Fine? So, using ruler and compass, question number 1. What we can do it here? Draw a line segment AP. So, we have been drawn a line segment AP. Now see this carefully. Since when we are drawing a line, we were putting two arrows on both the sides. Since line can be extended from both the sides, but line segment cannot be extended from both the sides. So what we can do it with this? Now here, what else is given? We have drawn a line segment AP. Mark any point M on it. So we have made a mark M or point M on somewhere on this AP. Now through M, draw a perpendicular to AB. So what we can do it here? We can draw an arc here. Then join the arc. And then this will be your perpendicular. Perpendicular to AB. Now this whole line, this can be named P and this can be anyway, some name we can take, give it. So both the side we can draw an arc and then we can make that perpendicular. PQ is perpendicular to AB. So what will be happen? PQ will be perpendicular to AB. So what we have done, we have made an arc. With that arc only put a cross here above. And down also we can do it in the same way. Then join it. Join point P from point Q and then your perpendicular will be formed. How will you find it out that whether it is perpendicular or not? So for that you can measure this angle. If this angle will be of 90 degree, then yes, it is a perpendicular. So this is your question 1 from your book. Now question 2, exercise 14.4, draw any line segment PQ. Take any point R not on it. Through R, draw a perpendicular to PQ. So use ruler and set square. So when you are using set square, how you can make it? Like question number 2. Question number 2. That is draw any line segment PQ. Draw any line segment PQ. So question number 2, what does it say? Is that draw any line segment PQ. Take any point R, not on it, through R draw a perpendicular to PQ. So any point R we have taken here. Then we will put set square opposite the conical, that one point will be towards this PQ. And then we will keep it here and then we will start dragging it from there. Somewhere it is finding here. And then we can join it and then this perpendicular will be formed. So that is another method to draw perpendicular on PQ through R. You can draw a perpendicular on PQ by using set square. Now again one more question, that is third one. Draw line L, a point X on it. Through X, draw line segment XY perpendicular to L. Again, XY perpendicular you can draw. Now, if we understood how to draw perpendicular, then we can easily draw perpendicular bisector of a line segment. So what do we mean by a perpendicular bisector of a line segment? Perpendicular bisector of a line segment is a perpendicular which divides the line into two equal halves. When we are drawing a perpendicular bisector to a line, that is dividing that line into two equal halves. That perpendicular is dividing that line into two equal halves. So perpendicular bisector is basically doing that only, that it is dividing. How you can identify whether it is dividing into two equal halves or not? So for that you can measure the both of the length. You can measure both of its length and then find it out whether it is dividing into two equal halves or not. So let's do exercise for next one, 14.5, that is related to perpendicular bisector only. This was question number 3. Then 14.5, which is related to perpendicular bisector. 14.5, which is related to perpendicular bisector. Draw AB of length 7.3 cm and find its axis of symmetry. Draw AB of length 7.3 cm and find its axis of symmetry. Axis of symmetry means that is your perpendicular bisector only. You need to divide line AB, which is given to you, that is 7.3 cm into two equal halves, and by that we will be doing by using axis of symmetry also, as well as the other name is construct its perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular bisector is also doing the same thing, that is dividing it, that line segment, into two equal halves. Now 14.5, question 1, draw AB of length 7.3 cm and find its axis of symmetry. So let's draw a line segment, that is 7.3 cm. So how we can draw a perpendicular bisector? So from here you can open it more than half, put across here, other side also, from here this and this, and then you can join it. When you are joining these two points, name it something, that is, or LMN, this will be AB, so here that will become line M is the axis of symmetry. So that will be your question number 1. Again, simple. Whenever you need to draw a perpendicular bisector, draw a line segment of given length, whatever length will be given to you, of that length you can draw it. And then put a compass here and then divide it into half. Open it more than half and then put an arc there also and here also, and then join these two parts. Now this perpendicular bisector can be considered as an axis. Line M is the axis of symmetry, since it is given, that is, draw AB of length this much and then draw axis of symmetry. Axis of symmetry is nothing but the perpendicular bisector only, which is dividing that given line into two equal halves. So draw a line segment of length 9.5 cm and construct its perpendicular bisector. Again, you can opt for this method only, and then you can draw this perpendicular bisector. Now, how you will be able to understand then that this perpendicular bisector is that only which we require to make it, that is, with the help of you are going to measure this angle. If the length or measurement of this angle will be 90 degree, then you can write or you can mention that yes, it is considered as an axis of symmetry, or perpendicular bisector is only considered as axis of symmetry. Actually, what is the similarity between perpendicular bisector and axis of symmetry? This axis of symmetry is also dividing a given figure or line into two equal parts, as well as both the parts are equal, and the angle which is formed by axis of symmetry is of 90 degree only. So with this, there are few common points that is related to axis of symmetry. So that is why we have taken this axis of symmetry here. So I hope this question is clear, that is related to perpendicular bisector. Now question number 2, draw a line segment of length 9.5 cm and construct its perpendicular bisector. Again, in the same way you can do it. Question number 2 of this exercise, question number 2 of exercise 14.5. So question number 2 says that draw a line segment of length 9.5 centimeter. Then we need to open it more than half. Put the arc here, and from this side here and here, and then join it, and then when after joining, it is forming perpendicular bisector, which is forming 90 degree angle with this line, baseline line segment. We can name it AB, 9.5 centimeter. AB we can mention here, that is 9.5 centimeter. Draw perpendicular bisector. How we can find it out, this perpendicular bisector? Is this a perpendicular bisector or not? So you can measure length of this part is equals to this part. If it is total 9.5 centimeter, so this part will be 9.5 divided by 2, and this part will be 9.5 divided by 2, and then you can find it out, yes, these two are equal, as well as this line, this bisector, perpendicular bisector is always forming 90 degree angle here. Draw the perpendicular bisector of XY whose length is again 10.3 cm. Take any point P on the bisector line. Examine whether PX is equals to PY. Again, you need to draw this perpendicular bisector only. Now, perpendicular bisector is quite easy, but the practice is needed, but the practice is required in all these questions. So, I hope this perpendicular bisector related question, that will be clear, and many questions related to this practical geometry, perpendicular bisector, axis of symmetry, many questions have been given in your book, and you just go through it and then drawing perpendicular bisector. Once the perpendicular bisector will be clear to you all, then we will be starting with angle bisector. How you are supposed to construct angles, how to construct, that is, how do you construct an angle? So I hope that how to draw a perpendicular bisector is clear to you all, but only 2 questions of exercise 14.5 we have seen. So tomorrow we will be doing this exercise 14.5 in continuation only. What all rest of the questions which have been left, that we will look into, construct a copy of an and along with this, we will be learning to form different angles with compass and ruler. So today I will be finishing the class here. That's all for today, children. Have a good day.